Hey everyone, Mitchell from MitchellGould.com, and in today's video, we're going to be adding the LinkedIn Insight tag to Squarespace website. We're going to do that first by installing the code manually, and then we're going to go over another option, installing it using Google Tag Manager. So let's go ahead and get started. We're in our LinkedIn Campaign Manager, our ads account. We're going to go to Analyze, click Insight Tag. If you haven't already, you're going to click Create Insight Tag, and you'll see this screen. And we're gonna go over this option. I will install the tag myself. So you can click that. Then we wanna copy this code. We need to add this code to Squarespace in the footer section. So we'll go to our Squarespace website in the configuration panel. We'll click website. We'll navigate down to website tools, code injection. You'll see in the code injection section, we can add code to the header and footer of our website. This will make sure the code is on every page of the site. So we'll go to the footer and we'll paste that code. And then at the top, we'll click save. And now the LinkedIn Insight tag has been added to our site. To verify that, we're gonna go into our site, just make sure things are refreshed. We're gonna go to this Chrome extension, the B2B House LinkedIn Insight Tag Checker, and we're gonna click inspect, and then we see our partner ID has been added successfully. So that's the first option. The second option is to use Google Tag Manager. So we'll go ahead and go through that now. Clear that, save it, so we're starting fresh. So we'll go back into the Insight tag and we'll go to this option. I will use a tag manager. And then we'll see our partner ID, which we'll need. But for now, we'll go into Google Tag Manager. And if you haven't already created an account, you can create an account. It only takes a minute to get things set up. And then you'll be on this screen here. We'll click our Google Tag Manager container ID, and that will pop up the code that needs to be installed on our website so that Google Tag Manager is active. So we'll copy this code that needs to be pasted in the head section. We'll go back to that same area in our Squarespace site, the code injection under website tools, and we'll go to the header section and we'll paste that in. Then we'll go back here, and the second code snippet says to paste in the body. We'll go into Squarespace and we can actually put that in the footer section. So we'll paste that and then we'll click save. And then we'll go back into Google Tag Manager. We'll go to tags. This is where we're gonna set up our LinkedIn Insight tag. So we'll go to new and we'll call this tag LinkedIn Insight. And then we'll click tag configuration and you'll go to discover more tag types in the community template gallery. Click that, click search and type LinkedIn. So you'll want to add this tag here, the LinkedIn Insight tag 2.0. I've already added it, so I'm going to exit out, but you'll add that. So you'll have the LinkedIn Insight tag 2.0, and then we need our partner ID. So we'll go back to LinkedIn. We'll copy our partner ID. We'll go to Tag Manager, and we'll paste that in. Then we'll go to the triggering section, click that, and we want this code to fire on all pages. So we'll click the All Pages option. And then we'll click save. You can then preview this to see if it's working. So we'll go to preview and we'll add in our website. We'll click connect and then we'll go back to our tag assistant tab. And then you can see tags fire, the LinkedIn Insight tag. So we know that it's working now. We can go back to Google Tag Manager and we'll click submit. This will publish the changes that we made. We can give it just a descriptive name, add a LinkedIn Insight tag, and then we'll click publish. So we publish our changes in Google Tag Manager. We can now go back to our website, refresh it. We're gonna go to the Chrome extension, the LinkedIn Insight Tag Checker, click inspect, and we can see that our partner ID was successful again. So we're all set there. So those are the two options. You can either install the code manually or you can use Google Tag Manager. I use Google Tag Manager a lot because you can consolidate all the tags, all the code snippets into one space. But yeah, if you have any questions on this, let me know in the comment section. I'd be happy to help out. Thanks and have a great day.